Welcome to St Mary's Church in the village of Hardwick, County Cambridgeshire, which is the last resting place of Major Michael Veal. My name is WO2 Martin Bessell. I served with the Royal Anglian Regiment in the 1970s, 1980s and 1990s and left as a company sergeant major. I first came across Michael Veal when I joined D Cambridgeshire Company, 6th Battalion, the Royal Anglian Regiment, back in the 70s. Michael very quickly went to Sandhurst, gained his commission, promoted to second lieutenant, and returned back to us as a platoon commander. Didn't stay with us very long, decided he needed some more experience, and pumped himself off to the 3rd Battalion, again as a lieutenant platoon commander. Stayed there a number of years. On returning to us, having gained a promotion, a lot more experience, and a few qualifications, I ended up with him as my platoon commander. I was fortunate, having returned from the Pompadours with all that experience, he joined my platoon. I was then a section commander. That's where I discovered he had more enough technical and physical abilities to be a platoon commander, but he had that special thing that we all would like to have, an automatic inbred ability to motivate and manage men and troops. He was really good at that. Of course, the powers that be soon realised that, and he was quickly worked off from us through different companies and battalion HQ and so on to gain more experience. However, he did return to us twice, once after he'd been promoted to captain to take over his company 2IC, and obviously a few years later as a major took over as company commander. Now, as a reserve soldier, we also Monday to Friday hold down a civilian job. Mike was no different, except he was still in the green because he served as a member of the permanent staff of the Cambridgeshire Army Cadet Force. Now, the Army Cadet Force once a year would take away their charges, that being the cadets and the volunteer instructors, away to for a 2-week annual camp, usually on a battle training area somewhere in the UK. So it came to be that in 1993, and in preparation for one of these next continuous training periods, Michael took away the volunteer instructors to the Yorkshire Dales. The plan being to get them to know the area a bit and a little bit of adventurous training to bring them together. Mike had a mantra, and that was very simple. Life is an adventure or nothing at all. So, Saturday, December the 18th, 1993, those men woke up with the idea of an adventure, specifically in Howsteen Gorge in Nidderdale. Unfortunately, the river that ran through Howsteen Gorge drowned two of them, Sergeant Jeremy Lander and our very own Michael Veal. The battalion officers then commissioned the Veal Trophy, which was passed to the brigade commander with the intent that that be presented as a prize for one of the events on a yearly event called the Brigade Military Skills Competition. This gave D Company a real incentive to win that competition and bring that trophy back to us. Well, 6 years after Michael's death, that company, his company, not only brought back the Veal Trophy, but every piece of silver off that table came back to Cambridge, complete year after year. When we closed in 1999, we still had every bit of silver in our trophy cabinet. I personally think that's a great accolade to his abilities to do it 6 years after he's dead. No, amazing man. In my opinion, there are very few like that. I think remembrance means two things to me. The first thing is, come 11 o'clock, remembering the ones that have gone beyond. And then after that, actually being with the guys that I serve with, having a drink and remembering, thinking of the dead and the ones that have left us.